Hi students and welcome back to bankexamsway.com. Today we are going to do a very important topic, that is sports news of 2018 at a glance. Why are we doing this? You must be thinking. There are two reasons for doing it. First is that when I was checking the question papers of RBI grade B, second that is SEBI grade A, and third was NABARD. These three important exams were organized in 2018. In all these exams, there were questions from sports, and not only the simple questions, the questions were quite complicated because the questions were from the topics we usually miss while reading the current affairs. So this is the very first reason of doing this topic, because we are in the last month of the year, and if you are going to appear for the exam in December 2018 or any exam that will be held between the first 3 months of 2019, then you must be aware about some current affairs of the previous year, that is 2018, right? So it is very important for the two reasons: to know about the sports events held in 2018, all the sports person, sports events and winners, right? So before we waste any minute, we will look at the very first topic. The very first news that I recently picked up is Ballon d'Or Award 2018. Basically, this award is given for the sport which is football. We all are aware about it, right? And the second interesting fact about this award is that two main footballers, that is Messi and Ronaldo, these two players were grabbing this award, Ballon d'Or award, from last many years, from the year it was introduced. But this year historical event happened, because Luka Modric, this Croatia's midfielder, won this award, breaking the chain of these two sportspersons' supremacy over this award. And second interesting fact that happened this year is that Ballon d'Or award was given to a woman, which never happened earlier in the history. The very first receiver of this award is Ada Hegerberg. So you need to remember two things here: that Luka Modric received this award in the men's category, and the first or the maiden or the introductory Ballon d'Or award for female football player was awarded to Ada Hegerberg. These two things are very, very important. Don't forget to learn them by heart. And the second is Syed Modi India Grand Prix Gold Badminton Title 2018. So basically, why do we give this award or the title? It is for the sport badminton. Sometimes the question in the exam is, to which sport does this particular title or this particular trophy is associated with? So if you are asked Syed Modi India Grand Prix, then you know it is associated with badminton. And then who won this title in 2018? It is Sameer Verma. You can be asked, to which sport Sameer Verma belong? And we know that he belongs to badminton. And in the final match, he defeated China's Liu Guangzhou. Okay, so two things to remember here. First, the trophy or the title is associated with badminton, and the 2018 winner of this title is Sameer Verma, who belongs to badminton sport. Moving to the third, very important, Hima Das. She became the first ever youth ambassador of UNICEF. Nothing like this ever happened earlier. So it is a historical moment It is a historical moment, and any question, you can get your question on this particular topic. So what is the news? That India's ace sprinter, Asian Games gold medalist, that Hima Das won gold medal in the Asian Games, was the first ever youth ambassador of United Nations Children Funds, that is UNICEF. And she is representing her ambassadorship in India only. Secondly, she was the first Indian athlete to win gold medal in track event at IAAF World Under 20 Championship in Tampere, Finland. Okay, so we need to know who this person is, because we are so obsessed with cricket that sometimes we forgot that there are other sports persons who are representing our nation to international levels, and we must appreciate them. And in 2018's Asian Games, which were recently concluded in Jakarta, Indonesia, she had won a silver medal in 400 meters race. She is nicknamed Dhing Express, which is the name of her village, and two from her village she is named Dhing Express. Okay, and secondly, very important thing is that she is the sports ambassador of Assam, the state she belongs to. Clear? So who is the very first first ever youth ambassador of UNICEF? That is Hima Das. Okay, the next is Asian Shotgun Championship. The very first thing is to remember here, to which sport does Angad Veer Singh Bajwa belong? And he belongs to shooting. There are people who do not know about this person. Even I wasn't aware about him until I prepared this PPT and research about him. So he won gold medal in men's skeet final. Skeet is a kind of event in shooting at the 8th Asian Shotgun Championship held in Kuwait. The only thing here is to remember who is the first Indian skeet shooter to win any continental or world event in shooting, and that is Angad Veer Singh Bajwa. Moving to the World Wrestling Championship, which was held in Budapest, Hungary, India just won two medals in this wrestling championship. First medal was silver and second was bronze. And the silver medal was won by Bajrang Punia, and the bronze medal was grabbed by Pooja Dhanda. And by receiving or by winning this title, she became the fourth Indian woman to win a medal at the World Wrestling Championship. Before her, only three women, Indian women, have won the medal, and she is the fourth one to win it. Two things to remember: Bajrang Punia belongs to which sport? He belongs to wrestling. Again, Pooja Dhanda, she belonged to wrestling once again. Okay, then another news from cricket is that Rahul Dravid is inducted to ICC's Hall of Fame. So by getting induction in ICC's Hall of Fame, he became the fifth Indian player to be a part of this Hall of Fame. Before him, Bishan Singh Bedi was the first one to be inducted, then Sunil Gavaskar, Kapil Dev and Anil Kumble. We hope that many of Indian cricket players will be inducted in this Hall of Fame, but right now we only have 5 players of India, and Rahul Dravid is the recent one to be inducted. Okay, and the induction ceremony was organized by Rahul Dravid was given the memento by Sunil Gavaskar at the Greenfield International Stadium in Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala. Another thing to remember, where is this stadium located? Greenfield International Stadium, it is located in Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala, because in the static JK you can be asked about the stadiums and their location. Moving to the Youth Olympic Championship, where we had two young participants, and this on Jeremy Lalrinunga. The question was asked in SEBI grade A exam. Because this exam was held, I think, in October, and this event was held in September. So the most of the question in the SEBI were from the recent current affairs, SEBI 2018 exam, in the SEBI grade A 2018 exam. So Jeremy Lalrinunga won gold medal at the 2018 World Youth Olympic Games, and these games were held in the Buenos Aires capital of Argentina. Again, from the same sport event, Thangjam Tababi Devi, she became the India's first judo medalist. India never won any medal in judo, but this girl broke the series and she won the medal by winning a silver medal. Then Asian Games, the very important news event from the Asian Game is that Japanese women's swimmer Rikaku Iki was given the most valuable players trophy at 2018 Jakarta Asian Games. So Asian Games were held in Jakarta, Indonesia, and in this particular event, Japanese women's swimmer Rikaku Iki was given the award of most valuable player. You can be asked this question in your upcoming exam, so don't forget it. PV Sindhu, my favorite sports person, and she became the 7th highest earning women's sports person in the world according to Forbes list. The list is recently released and it was topped by Serena Williams. Secondly, she won the silver medal at World Championship 2018 organized in China. Okay, so these two are the achievements of PV Sindhu in 2018, that she won a silver medal in the World Championship and she was the 7th highest earning sports person. Another historical event happened in the track cycling. Because India's teen cyclist Aso Elban created history by winning world's maiden, or our country, India's first maiden medal in the track cycling. He won the silver medal in men's Keirin event organized in Switzerland. So this question is again very important because we are expecting the unexpected in the upcoming exams. So if you are preparing for RBI grade B, NABARD grade A, or any other exam which is of scale 1 and scale 2 level, then prepare for the unexpected. Sultan Azlan Shah Cup, it is associated with hockey and mainly this event is organized in Malaysia. The 27th edition of Sultan Azlan Shah Cup was won by Australia and it was the 10th time Australian team grabbed this award. Okay, so they are having a kind of monopoly over this award, and this is a field hockey tournament only for men's. This tournament was named after Malaysian king, father of Malaysian hockey, Sultan Azlan Shah. So, which team won Sultan Azlan Shah Cup 2018? It was Australia, and this team won this game or won this trophy for the 10th time, setting a record. The other top trophy, it is associated with cricket and it is a domestic cricket event won by India B team. So, in this, there are three teams chosen by BCCI, India A, India B and India C, and India B won the trophy. This trophy is named after Professor D.B. Deodhar, who is also known as the Grand Old Man of Indian Cricket. This is not that important, but you can be asked to which sport this trophy belongs. So you know it is for cricket. senior Asian championship. Navjot Kaur grabs gold. So who is Navjot Kaur? She is a wrestler and she won gold medal in the 65 kg freestyle wrestling category in the Asian championship held in Bishkek, Kyrgyzstan. She is the first Indian woman to win any gold medal in senior Asian championships. Before her, no other Indian female wrestler could do it. So she set a world record, so we must remember her because question can be asked. Satyarupa Siddhanta climbed Mount Ojo del Salado. This mountain is the highest volcano in the world, located on the Argentina-Chile border, and Satyarupa Siddhanta became the second Indian to climb this mountain. Sunil Chhetri, we all know about this news because it was all over the social media when Sunil Chhetri set the world record of scoring second highest international goal scorer, competing with Messi. Right? So people were, he and Messi are at the same level. So Sunil Chhetri became the second highest international goal scorer among the active players along with Argentina superstar footballer Messi, and he achieved this after he scored 64th goal in the match between India and Kenya. So you remember him because he contributed in India's pride and brought us laurels, because that is something nobody, not everyone's cup of tea. Sharing a record with Messi is itself a great deal. So we must appreciate him. France won the FIFA World Cup. We all know that the France won the FIFA World Cup by defeating Croatia in Moscow, Russia. So there is nothing to elaborate here. This is important. Deepa Karamkar again created history by becoming first Indian gymnast to win gold medal in the vault event, in which few gymnasts can go or for qualify for this event at the FIG Artistic Gymnast World Challenge Cup at Mersin, Turkey. This is again very important because she created history of becoming the first Indian woman to be making her space in the vault event. Now we are moving to the Asian Games recently concluded and India's performance in this particular sports event. The very first is Swapna Barman. She is an athlete and she won gold medal in women's heptathlon athletics event. And with this gold, she became the first Indian woman to receive any gold in this heptathlete event. Secondly, Arpinder Singh won the gold medal in triple jump event. Tejinder Pal Singh Tour, who is a shot putter, won the gold medal. Again, we have gold. Then, tennis pair of Rohan Bopanna and Divij Sharan won gold medal in men's tennis. Saurabh Chaudhary, the shooter, won the gold medal once again. And Vinesh Phogat in wrestling won the gold medal. The only bronze we got is the 4 bronze in the Wushu sporting event. And the 4 bronze medals were brought by Roshi, Beena Devi, Santosh Kumar, Surya Bhanu Pratap Singh and Narendra Grewal. So you must remember the name of the sports person. And to which sport they belong. Moving to the miscellaneous news in the sports field, that India won the under 19 ICC World Cup by defeating Australia. Okay. And with this victory, India became the first nation to win under 19 World Cup 4 times. Round of applause for the Indian team. Then Roger Federer. He won the Australian Open title, men's single. Vidarbha cricket team won the Ranji Trophy. Ranji Trophy is again associated with cricket. Chess Grandmaster Vishwanathan Anand won World Rapid Chess Championship title. India's Saiko Mirabai Chanu won the gold medal at World Weightlifting Championship. And the two news pieces from the political aspects that Indian Ministry of Sports has included entire hockey team of India under Target Olympic Podium Scheme, in which only the single sport person was allowed to enter. So the hockey team is the first one to be included. Secondly, the cabinet has approved that India's first national sports university will be built in Imphal, Manipur. And the sad news came from cricket that Gautam Gambhir announced his retirement recently. So this is all about the sports events, news and sports person in 2018. If you have any doubt, this is the email ID where you drop your queries. insa@bankexamstoday.com. I don't want to spoil this. Thank you, glittery. Thank you. So thank you for watching this video, devoting your time and learning something new. Keep practicing. Happy learning.